24, verse 42. Watch therefore, for you do not know the hour your Lord is coming. I want you to know, church, that Jesus Christ could come this month, or he might come next week, or he could even come.
Why does our culture and our world continue to spin deeper and deeper down the drain of sewage and depravity? Everywhere we look, good is called evil and evil is called good. Everything is backwards from God's natural order. Everything is demonic counterfeit of God's perfect plan and design. Today I want to read you Romans 1. It seems God has given the world over to depraved, reprobate minds, vile affections, bloodlust, worship of false gods. Filled with all unrighteousness, fornication, wickedness, covetousness, maliciousness, full of envy, murder, debate, deceit, malignity, whisperers, backbiters, haters of God, spiteful, proud, boasters, inventors of evil things, disobedient to parents, without understanding, covenant breakers, without natural affection, even for their own children, undiscerning, untrustworthy, unloving, and unmerciful. I mean, is it any wonder that God has given most people in this world over to corrupt minds? A dark cloud of judgment has fallen upon our land, and it's our own fault. Why is the church today so powerless? Outwardly, they practice a form of godliness, but they deny the power of God. I dare say that most professing Christians and churchgoers today are just as carnal as the worldly. They may act holy during the worshiptainment, they enjoy their local God Mart, but they really have no idea whatsoever what being a Christ follower is really all about. Salt has lost the savor, therefore useless, except to be thrown out and trampled under the feet of men. That is, if they ever had any salt to begin with. Increasingly, Lucifer and his demons are reigning on this earth. Mind you, it's only because God Almighty allows it, for now. But nevertheless, the demonic realm is very real and very effective at destroying all who will fall for his lies and deceptions. And make no mistake, all he offers are lies and deceptions, because he's the father of lies and there's no truth in him. His goal is to lie, and deceive, and twist as many minds into godless rebellion as possible, leading to the ultimate death and destruction of as many of God's image bearers as possible. That means you, friend. We are all targets, simply because we are made in God's image, and through our Creator is not willing that any should perish. Most will, and by their own choice. One day the sons of God came to present themselves before the Lord, and Satan also came with them. The Lord asked Satan, "Where have you come from?" "From roaming the earth," Satan answered him, "and walking around on it." Job 1:6. "Your heart became proud because of your beauty. For the sake of your splendor, you corrupted your wisdom. So I threw you down to earth." Ezekiel 28:17. Yes, Satan is a created being and was anointed by God and given the position of guardian. But he rebelled against the Most High, and he was cast down to earth, where he remains today, as the father of lies, the enemy of our souls. 1 Peter 5 warns us now that he prowls around like a roaring lion, seeking whomever he may devour. We are therefore warned to be sober-minded and watchful, and we have God's promise that if we resist him, firm in our faith, he will flee from us. You see, he has to, because if we have the Holy Spirit of God within us, and not all who claim the name of Christ actually do, then we have the very power and authority of God within us to also trample Satan beneath our feet. In Matthew 28, starting at verse 18, "Then Jesus came near and said to them, 'All authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe everything I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age.'" Yes, Jesus is with us. He is in us, and he gives us his authority on this earth. And the authority of God includes authority over the devil and his demons. Friends, do you realize, do you really understand that the supernatural spiritual realm is real and present right alongside us? Though we cannot see it in the natural, it's no less real. Demons and angels walk among us on this earth, and the spiritual battle rages in the heavenlies and in this world. Satan commands legions of demons to do his evil bidding among us every day, but he can only do this if we allow it and open the doors to the demonic. But knowing that God is infinitely more powerful than the father of lies, knowing that Jesus Christ himself was manifested in this world, died and was buried and rose again that he might destroy the works of the devil, why then is this world descending so rapidly now into utter destruction? Timothy 4. Now the Spirit explicitly says that in latter times some will depart from the faith, paying attention to deceitful spirits and teachings of demons through the hypocrisy of liars whose consciences are seared. I could do an entire video on that verse alone. Today many have departed. Many are following the deceitful spirits and teachings of demons. And this scripture tells us that these demonic teachings come through the hypocrisy of liars whose consciences are seared. Dare I say that many, if not most, of our churches today have become nothing more than a carnal, satanic social club, where professing pastors never address the topics of spiritual warfare, hireling shepherds that will never talk about the social, cultural, moral, and political issues that are twisting our own minds and those of our children, destroying marriages, and even redefining marriage, tearing apart families and dragging millions of souls to hell every day. By their silence, they have given their consent. And sadly, there are now an increasing number of churches celebrating all this wickedness as well. Not just remaining silent, now they are advocating and celebrating sodomy, infanticide, Islam, fornication, pornography, socialism, fascism, and more. Paul wrote to the Corinthians, "I fear that the serpent has deceived Eve by his cunning. Your minds may be seduced from a complete and pure devotion to Christ. For if a person comes and preaches another Jesus, whom we did not preach, or you receive a different spirit, which you had not received, or a different gospel, which you had not accepted, you put up with it splendidly." Yes, there are many false Christs and false gospels and false spirits being preached today, and there are many who put up with it splendidly. God has placed before us a choice between life and death, and sadly most have chosen the broad path that leads to destruction. Even most who attend church regularly and do all the vain religious rituals have neglected entirely the weightier matters. But Paul continued. He said, "Since we have the ministry because we were shown mercy, we do not give up. Instead, we have renounced shameful secret things, not walking in deceit or distorting God's message, but commending ourselves to every person's conscience in God's sight by an open display of the truth. But if our gospel is veiled, it is veiled to those who are perishing. In their case, the God of this age has blinded the minds of the unbelievers so they cannot see the light of the gospel of the glory of Christ, who is an image of God." So what an admonition. We are not to walk in deceit or distort God's message, but seek to touch every person's conscience. How? By an open display of the truth. We are not to tell the carnal, worldly person, "Jesus loves you, brother, just the way you are." That's a lie. It's a lie from the father of lies himself. Until we come to Christ in humble repentance and faith, we remain under God's wrath, an enemy of the cross. And scripture tells us we are of our father, the devil, and the deeds of our father we will do. And that's not okay. God is not all right with that. The wages of sin are death. Instead, as much as we are able, with all of our might, through the power of the Holy Spirit within us, we are to present to every person's conscience an open display of the truth, unashamedly, boldly, but humbly. But the world is growing darker and at an alarming speed. Why is evil getting so bold so quickly? Why are we seeing things coming upon earth now that we would have never dreamed of possible a few years ago? I'll tell you why. Because we have opened the doors. We have rolled out the red carpet and we have opened portals into the demonic spiritual realm. We have done this by believing lies, by hiding from God's light. We do this every day through the entertainment that we choose, through the sin habits we continue to indulge in, through continuing to allow millions of babies to be slaughtered in the womb. And make no mistake, the devil and his demons feed on the blood of the innocent. The blood of the innocent is currency in the demonic spiritual realm. We are under blood guiltness, but few professing Christians can be bothered to actually do anything about it or demand justice. The same is true with the sodomite agenda. Christians remain silent. Pastors remain silent on all of these things, as thousands upon thousands of our young people and young children are indoctrinated into death style. Parents even march their little kids in the pride parades and take them to drag queen story time at the local libraries. Countless children and young people are lured into human trafficking market, sold as slaves and prostitutes. And then we celebrate the death cult of Islam, welcoming demon worshippers into high places in government, education, media, and other areas of great influence. I could go on. The indoctrination of children in public schools, and the rest of us through constant use of our screens, the invasion of our country by hostile foreign enemies, the list is endless. And we do all of this with pride. Yes, we have willingly opened massive portals to the demonic realm, pardon me, allowing an ever-increasing number of demons to have free reign in every area of our lives and our world. As we invite and welcome and celebrate the arrival of more and more demons, we seal our fate. Only God's faithful remnant will find eternal life with him. We must press on. We must boldly proclaim truth at every opportunity and seek and demand the righteousness and justice. Most of all, we must remember the words of Moses and actually do what we have so woefully failed at from Deuteronomy 6. Love the Lord God with all of your heart, with all of your soul, with all of your strength. These words I'm giving you today to be in your heart. Repeat them to your children. Talk about them when you sit in your house and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. Bind them as a sign on your hand and let them be a symbol on your forehead. Write them on the doorpost of your house and on your gates. Folks, this is a spiritual battle. It's spiritual warfare. It's real, it's intense, and the enemy is seeking to devour all of us, especially our precious children. We need to step up our game. We need to amp it up. We need to be bold warriors for Christ, seeking a restraining influence against the enemy. But we can never do that if we never speak up or never leave the four walls of our local religious service providers. Salt that has lost its savor cannot be made salty again. It's too late for them, but not for the faithful. Now is the time. Today is the day for us to believe what Jesus said. We have all authority over the enemy. Jesus will be with us even to the end of the age. Christ is in us, and as his disciples, we have the very authority of God to cast these demons out, and they have no choice but to obey. When we understand and believe that authority and come out of our hiding places and begin to exercise it, just as Jesus commanded. And ladies and gentlemen, that's my message for today. I do apologize for the slight delay. I think we had about 4 days with no new videos. I had to step back a little bit and kind of pray about this channel and what direction God wanted to send this thing. We put in several hours a day creating these, and I want to just be sure that I'm hitting all the right notes in God's eyes and not for mine. So again, until next time, God bless you and your families. Thank you very much. Please like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, thank you.